Hey everyone, welcome back to my next project. Just like the sign says, welcome to Dirk's next disaster build. Yes, disaster. If you enjoy watching me butcher styrene and plastic, you're gonna love this next build. For this next build, I'm going way out into the deep end. I'm going in way, way over my head. I'm going to attempt to build a paper model. Yep. Don't get me wrong, I'm not leaving styrene. I still love it. And plus, I've got so many kits, I'd have to slice my wrist if I decided to not build them anymore. No, I just decided to try something new. For years, I've come across some paper modelers out there, and I've been fascinated with their craft. There's one gentleman over on the unofficial Airfix modeling forum named Simon O'Neill, and he does some really great work with paper, and he kind of got me drawn into it. And we've talked about it over and over again. I'm going to try something. And, you know, I just get involved with other projects. I just lose interest, what have you. You know, the ADD kicks in and I forget about it. And then recently on the Amazing Plastic Google Plus community, I came across a gentleman named James Frost. And this gentleman makes the most incredible paper models I've ever seen. Absolutely blown away with this man's skills. It's incredible. So, looking at what he's done made me want to try it. I don't know if I'm going to like it. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. Hence the disaster part. I mean, you can have all the want and desire you want, but you just may not be able to do it. So, we'll have to see. Now, what's cool about paper products? I mean, well, the neat thing is there are so many subjects out there that aren't available in styrene or resin that you can do. I mean, there are cars and there's buildings and there's aircraft and there's all kinds of stuff. Boats. The first kit that I got attracted to in boats was the Titanic, the Olympic, and the Britannic. I saw them in paper model, and I want to do them. I have the kits on my computer. I just haven't done it yet. But there's just nothing you can't really do. Now, I have to admit, I'm not really partial to the cars and the buildings and such. I've seen some airplanes that have been phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. But the real kicker for me is the sci-fi stuff. I mean, I like to cross genres. I do everything from figures and cars and, you know, boat here and there to some armor and sci-fi. But sci-fi subjects are the ones that are really amazing in the paper model craft. I mean, there are subjects that they just don't make in styrene. And the one that I had chose to build was this one right here. The Battlestar Galactica Colonial Shuttle. This is from the original series, the TOS series. I thought this was really cool, and I wanted to build it. And one of the things you need when you do paper modeling is a printer. Because you see, you don't have to go out to the store to buy your models and spend tons of money on them. Oh, you can, but you don't have to, because there's just hundreds and hundreds of things out there that are available for free, such as this one. I just don't happen to have a working printer right now, so it kind of put me off for a while trying to do it, and I finally got somebody at work that has a color printer to do it. So this is the one I had chose. Here's the instruction sheet for it. Couple pages, and then here's the sheet, the actual parts. paper is your sprue when it comes to paper modeling. You know, 3 pages. Now, I was talking to the lady who was doing this for me. She's our resident Photoshop pro and stuff like that. Anytime I need something done, I see her and she can print it out and what have you. But what I sat down with her and we started going over it, and when we printed this first page out, I actually had to resize it to fit on the page for some reason. And then I went off to do some work and I left her to doing her stuff. When she brought me the parts, you can see this one, she fit it with Photoshop to fit the paper very nicely. But these 2 sheets didn't. They actually ran off. There's more parts down here that's missing. So basically what I'm getting at is when you're printing them out, the sheets, the print, you have to do it all on the same scale because otherwise the parts don't fit. And when I talked to her today, she realized that no, they're not to scale. The 3 sheets are different scales. So this wouldn't work. That's a lot of parts for me to cut out to realize that I made a mistake. So this right now is garbage. I will get back to this one later. Not to mention the fact that this is a lot of parts and it's way over my head for a beginner. My eyes are bigger than my skill. But I still want to do paper. So I decided I'm going to toss this one out because this is no good. I'm going to find something else that's a little simpler, yet cool. Got to be cool. And what I found out this time was this one. This one is a sci-fi kit. Okay. This one is a Star Trek kit. So that should pique the interest of some people. What I decided to do is the Star Trek travel pod from the motion picture. If you remember, that was the one that Kirk and Scotty got in, and it traveled from the base and flew over to the Enterprise. It was the first look we got at the refit Enterprise. It was in this little travel pod. So the neat thing about this is, on this one, it's only 1 page of parts. That's all it is. So we're looking at 10 parts about, okay? So it's a lot simpler than that Colonial Shuttle. So I figured this would be a good idea. Now, the other neat thing about paper, I had her print out 2 sheets for me. These are 2 identical sheets. Why? Because if I screw something up on here, I could just print another copy. And I cut it out and have another part again. If it was styrene, I'd have to contact the vendor and wait weeks and weeks and weeks if they were to help me out. Because a lot of the kits I have are out of production. Or I would have to try to recreate or replicate that part in resin, which is a very expensive venture. Again, this, free. The paper for me was free because I happened to go through the paper. I decided I didn't want to go out and buy paper yet because I didn't want to waste the money if I don't like it. So I just was going through the stationery at the office, and I found this. This is like make your own greeting card stuff. This might not be the right grade paper for this project, but it's a good starting point, I feel, because it'll give me a feel of what it's supposed to be like, what I'm supposed to do. And again, the kit cost me nothing. The paper cost me nothing. I already have the tools I need. So in the end, if I screw it up or if I find out I don't like it, it didn't cost me anything. So it's a really neat little venture. And as you can see also, the parts are already colored. There's no painting involved. So that's another neat thing about paper. Even if you like to paint your models, let's say it's winter out. We just got out of a winter here in the States. It was a pretty cold winter. A lot of us were stuck inside a lot. And I remember being on Hangouts with some people that were saying how they can't do any modeling because they can't paint. It's too cold outside. They can't paint in their house. Well, guess what? With this, you could still have the satisfaction of building something without having to paint it. So it's really, really neat. Now, this hobby can get very, very, very involved. Just like styrene hobbies. I mean, I started out with one brush, I think, and a couple jars of paint, a couple cans, and a disposable utility knife. Now, I can't even fathom the amount of tools, paints, and all kinds of glues and all that stuff that I have around my bench anymore. You could go crazy with paper, but you don't have to. Let's take a look at the tools that you need to do this hobby. Now, also, real quick, I by no means am an expert with paper. I am not. I've just been reading and researching to try to get my head around it, see if I can do this. So, please, I'm not an expert. There are other people that are far better at this than I am. Of course, they're better than it because I've done it. I've never done it. So, simply put, to get started, you need a card paper. Okay, a thicker paper. For example, this is just a regular sheet of everyday paper. This isn't enough to support the model itself. You need something thicker. Paper comes in different densities. Okay, I honestly do not know what the density is on this. It's just paper thicker than the rest of this, so I decided I'd try it. Again, it was free. This is just a test. Okay, but when you are really getting serious about it, you do need to get some real quality paper, okay? And paper, if you didn't know, is measured in what's called GSM. I think it's pronounced grammage, okay? The higher the number, the thicker the paper. For models, from what I understand, you want to be anywhere between 100 to maybe 210. Okay, the lower numbers are better for smaller models, so like your 100 to maybe 110, 120 maybe, for smaller ones, but the larger you get, you want to get something bigger. So you're going to hit, like the large models are going to be around maybe 180 to 210, depending on how big it is, because you want something that's going to support itself. Paper modeling also, I've seen people use actual cardboard boxes for support structures on the interiors. Okay, I've also seen people use wood. Paper clips sometimes come into play to help put your model together. I mean, in this hobby, they use anything. It's very much like styrene when you use whatever works to make that model look good. Same thing with this. So you got your paper. Okay, that's key. Another thing, a nice mat. Okay, you're going to be doing a lot of cutting and stuff like that. You want a decent mat. Next, crucial, a good pair of scissors. Okay, as you can see on this model here, okay, there's some fine detail that you are going to need to be able to get in. You're going to have to cut in all of these little tabs. So you need a decent pair of scissors, okay? I don't think granny scissors will do very good. There are all kinds of scissors, and I'm sure the best modelers out there have many different pairs. The pair that I chose right here, that I almost stabbed myself with, these are scissors that you find in medical packs for doing sutures and stuff. It's got a nice tight cut to it, small, it's easy to get around in. These are very cool scissors. Again, don't need a bunch of them right now, just need one to start, and that's what I've got. The other thing you're gonna need, tweezers. A hobby knife, very sharp, okay? You're gonna need that to cut odds and ends and bits and pieces just like you do with your styrene. They also say you should use a softer, rounder knife. This is a lot duller than this one here. And supposedly this will help you to score those tabs right here. This is your part and this here is a tab. This is the part you're going to fold over. To get it to fold properly and to maintain its spot, you want to be able to give it a score with this duller knife, just enough to break the surface and allow it to bend better. Okay? You don't want to use a sharp one, because a sharp one you'll probably cut through without even trying. So you have another knife. Then a ruler. Personally, I use two rulers, or I plan on using two rulers. If you've been doing any kind of styrene model for a while, and you've tried venturing into photo etch, that's what this hobby is like. It's like doing photo etch. These tabs, it's going to be the same thing. You're going to lay your flat edge down on an edge where you want to bend, and you can take your next one, bring it up underneath, and you fold it, and you get a nice straight edge. It's very similar to using something like this. This is called the bug for using to bend photo etch. You put your piece of photo etch underneath here in any of these slots, depending on how you want to bend it. You securely put it down. You take a razor blade in this case, you slide it under the photo etch, and you bend it up. And this holds it in place and gives you a nice crisp line. That's exactly what you're doing, the skill you'll be implementing with using paper. Now this ruler here might be a little bit too big, I'll have to figure it out, but two rulers would work because you can do the exact same thing. You're going to take one under the other to the edge, and you're going to help fold and create creases. Toothpicks. Could be, I don't know if I need it with this one, but toothpicks are another good thing to use for structural support on your paper models. Paints. We don't need them. That's a neat thing. No paint with this. It's already painted. Well, that's about it for right now, guys. That's the intro to this. It's very inexpensive. It has cost me zero right now out of pocket to get all this together to try it. It could probably, the same thing with each and every one of you out there, could cost you zero to try this, to try something new. And the amount of kits out there are just unbelievable. Again, cars. There's some figures. I've seen people take paper and make a mask. And then after they were done, they put some sort of material on it, and it's actually that paper mask has been turned into a hard plastic fiberglass type mask that you can wear. It's absolutely unbelievable. I actually saw somebody also online make a complete entire RoboCop suit out of paper and cardboard, and they wore it for a Halloween costume. It was amazing. Very, very cool. So, like I said, I'm not trying to sway anyone away from styrene. Just trying to get maybe somebody might want to venture into this with me and try a little bit something different, something out of your comfort zone. You get away from what you do every day, and then you go back to it later on, you have a better appreciation for it. So, you never know. It could be something you like to do anyway. Doing the same thing over and over gets kind of boring. Kind of like marriage. It just gets boring and boring after a while. Same thing. I jest because I was married and got divorced. So I'm bitter. But anyway, I'm joking. But anyway, that's it for now. Hopefully I'll have more to show you next time. We're going to start cutting out these parts, and we'll get back to it later. So until next time, be strong.